Net effective area of a member when subjected to rupture failure. If the fasteners are arranged in a staggered, zigzag or diamond, then the net effective area along the critical line will increase by P square T by 4G. PS is the staggered pitch, G is the gauge. And if you look at the equation of a critical section, in general, the net area AN is equal to width into thickness. See, that is the cross-section area which resists the tensile force. And if you look at the cross-section area which resists the tensile force in picture, it looks like this. This is the area which resists the tension force. This is the thickness of the tension member, and width of the tension member is this. So width into thickness is the area which resists the tensile force. Since we are making hole to connect two members, so that is where there is a reduction in area happens. So net area, if you look at this cross section, let's take this section. Let's name this section as 1, 2 and 3. The section 1, 2 and 3, if you take the section 1, 2 and 3, it looks like this. In 3D, there is a one hole. In the member. So this is the area, net area, and here you have a hole. And if you take the width, it is this. This is the width in resisting the tension force, and this is the thickness. So if you look at the net area is width minus, if this is the dia of hole, see, this is the, not dia of fasteners, it is the dia of hole, because we are discussing about the tension member. So minus dia of hole into thickness, that is the net area of the member at section 1, 2, 3. Let's take the section like this now, okay? So, if the plate fails like this, as we have discussed, let's see the plate failure of this pattern. Now look at this picture. In the first picture here, the bolts are arranged in a chain pattern, and the failure happened like this, rupture failure. And if you look at the equation, net area is width, see how many dia is there, 2 whole dia, so that is the area reduction in the length reduction in the width, into thickness. See, that is the cross section area of this section. Let's name this section as 1, 2, 3, 4. So this section, net area of 1, 2, 3, 4 section is D minus 2 times the dia of hole, that is the reduction in the width, into thickness. Again, why section has to fail? Why not the failure has not happened at this junction, at that critical section? Why the failure has happened only in the section 1, 2, 3, 4? Why not in the section 5, 6, 7, 8? Because if you look closely, these two members are connected by lap joint like this. This member is here, okay? Then it is subjected to a tensile force. Now the failure has happened at this junction in the top plate here. So the failure won't happen at this junction in that top plate, for this plate. Failure won't happen at this junction for the top plate here, because even if the failure happens here, the connection won't fail. because there is a bolt at these two places where it is holding, because the failure has happened only at this junction. Still, there are two bolts which holds top plate and bottom plate together. Only if the failure happens at this place, the connection will fail. So typically, the strength at this, if you look at this equation, the strength at a critical section is 0.9 times Fu upon gamma m1 into net area. That is for the cross section of 1, 2, 3, 4. If you calculate the strength of this section 5, 6, 7, 8, the section 5, 6, 7, 8, this critical section, then your equation becomes this value plus 2 times the strength of bolt. Because even if the failure happens at this cross section, only if these two bolts fail, either in a shear or a bearing, then only this connection will fail. So that is why when you calculate the strength of section 5, 6, 7, 8, rupture strength of section 5, 6, 7, 8, you need to include the strength of two bolts, because there are two more bolts which is holding the connection, to the total strength due to rupture. And yeah, that is how you need to calculate the net cross section area for a chain connection. It is simple. Net area is B minus N times the dia of fold into thickness. So why N? See, sometimes you may have even 3 number of bolts in a chain. So you need to substitute N as a 3. Sometimes you may have 4. Sometimes you may only have 1. So again, it depends. So that is why in general, D minus N DH into T. That is the net area of the member. Now look at this section. Now the bolts are arranged in a staggered pattern. So for staggered arrangement, now failure has started from here, then it prolonged to this hole, then the failure happened like this. So here the failure is not a straight failure, so you have an inclined path of failure also. Again, the failure has not happened at this portion in the top plate, because even if the failure happens, there are two more bolts to hold this plate with the bottom plate. So on the other hand, if you look at the bottom plate, if the failure will happen, if failure happens, then it will happen only at this section, because the strength at this critical section is lesser than the strength at this critical section, because at this section the net area is same, okay, in both the section, but here there are two more bolt strength, bolt value, there are two more bolt value which adds to the strength of this critical section. That is why the rupture strength of this section is lesser than the strength of this section. If bottom plate fails, it will fail only at this junction, not here. Okay. In top plate, the failure will happen only at this section, not at this section, because the strength is, rupture strength is more in this section compared to this cross section. Okay, now let's come to the net area calculation. For this failure pattern, net area is, again, if you look at the cross section in 3D, it looks like this, a hole, then incline, a hole, then straight. Now, can you understand, here is the net area and the inclined cross section and here. So that is the, cross section area of this failure path. Now let's calculate. As given in IS 800 2007, now if you take this picture, this is the load direction. Now pitch, staggered pitch is the distance between two adjacent pitch in the load direction. This is the PS. Gauge is in the perpendicular direction between two consecutive members. This is the gauge. So the width, because of this inclined line, the width has to be increased by P square T upon 4G. This is the increase in width because of this inclined line. You know, if this is 4, if this is 3, then hypotenuse is 5. We know that. So hypotenuse length is always more than the vertical length. So similarly, we need to increase the width or the total area. If you have, whenever you have a staggered line, failure line, then the area has to be increased. No, this is the increase in area. Area has to be increased of P square by 4G into thickness. So this is the increase in area because of this staggered line. Now if you look at the equation, net area of rupture is width minus N times the diameter hole, because there is area loss because of the hole. And what about the number of hole? We need to substitute that number. N is the number of hole in that failure path. So it has to be, width has to be increased by P square upon 4G. Whole thing has to be multiplied with P. So increase in width is P square by 4G because of staggered failure path. Increase in area is P square T upon 4G because of staggered line in the failure path. So staggered connection is superior than the chain connection because it has more area at a rupture section, and since the area is more, the load carrying capacity due to rupture is also more when the connection is staggered. That is why staggered connection is always superior than the chain connection. And here are the few pictures where one is arranged in a chain pattern and another set of bolts are arranged in a staggered pattern. And if this is the failure path, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this could be another failure path, like 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. AN is equal to total width minus, now this cross, we are working for this cross.
Hello.
Now we are calculating for this cross section 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 failure path. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this path. Failure path net area is equal to width minus N times dia 4 into sigma. Now how many number of bolts are there? 1, 2, 3 bolts are there. So your net area comes like this. Net area is D minus 3 times the dia 4 into thickness. This is the net area of section 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now if you look at the staggered arrangement, now the bolt are, now if you look at the staggered arrangement, the rupture may happen in this path, like 1, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The rupture may happen in this path, or from here the crack will start and it will propagate to this, because here is the nearest hole. See, from here If the crack wants to propagate, it will search the nearest hole where it is easy to propagate. The crack is easy to propagate. And here is the nearest hole. So the crack will follow this path. Then from here, the nearest is this hole. Okay, from here, the nearest is this hole. And then from here, the nearest is this hole. Then the failure may happen. Okay, so this path 1, 2, 6, 3, 7, 4, 5. So now one path is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, that is the failure path. And the other path is 1, 2, 6, 3, 7, 4, 5. Even failure can happen in that path. So which path I have to consider? We need to find the area, different area of a different cross section. We need to find area of a different critical cross section, and whichever is least is the governing area for the rupture failure of a tension member. And for this stagger 1, 2, 6, 3, 7, 4, 5, let me write a net area equation. An is B minus how many number of holes are there in that failure path? So one hole, okay, so one hole, 2, 3, 4, 5, because that is our failure path. So in that failure path we have a 5 dia of hole. I'm writing here plus increase in width due to the staggered line. How many staggered line? We have one staggered line, two staggered line, three and four. There are four staggered lines in our failure path. So the pitch, okay, so this is the pitch, PS, staggered pitch of this staggered line, and this is the gauge of this stagger line. If the pitch and the gauge of this stagger line for all the stagger line is same, okay, then we can say, like, how many stagger lines? There are four stagger lines. So 4 into pitch square, staggered pitch square, upon 4 times the gauge, the total value should be multiplied with the thickness. This number represents the number of staggered lines. So in your failure path, if there is only 2 staggered lines, then this number has to be 2. This is how you need to calculate the net effective section. Before concluding the net effective area of a critical section at rupture failure, I need to discuss few things. Which is the critical section of the rupture failure? Now, there are two arrangements. One is the lap and other one is butt. So, in lap joint, one member is at the top and other member is at the bottom. It is lapped together and bolted. And for the top member, if the failure happens here, that means if the plate cuts here, okay, then if you apply the load, then this member will come out. That means the failure will happen in a joint. So that is the critical section. Even the section of this path, if the failure happens at this section in the top plate, that means here, okay. So if you apply the load, then this plate will tear off. So that is also considered failure. But the failure won't happen at this path or this way. So because in both this failure path, there is a two bolt which holds the top plate with the bottom plate. So basically, the failure of these two failure paths, the rupture strength of these two failure paths is much higher than the rupture strength of this critical section. So that is why either section like this or section like this is the critical section for the top plate. For the bottom plate, the section here or here, this two is the critical section for the bottom plate. So you need to calculate the critical section more carefully. And if you look at the butt joint, this is the butt joint. If you look at the butt joint, there is a four member in this joint. Two are the main member, which takes the tension load, and two are the cover plate, top and bottom cover plate, which is used only in the connection. Okay, if you take the tension member, the critical section is very close to the butt joint. If you take the tension member, the critical section is away from the butt joint. For this tension member, the critical section is here. If the failure happens, if the plate cuts at this section, this plate will come off. Then it is called as a connection failure. And also for this plate, the critical section is away from the butt joint here. You can even consider 2-3 sections, then find out which is the least area. Then you calculate the strength at that least area. That is the rupture strength of the tension member. Then even you can consider like this. This is also one of the failure path where there should not be any bolt on this side of the connection. And here also you can consider like this. There should not be any hole on this side of the connection. And that is the critical section for the tension member, which is away from the butt joint. If you look at the critical section for the cover plate, it has to be very close to the butt joint. So this is the critical section of failure for the cover plate. So there are two cover plate, both the cover plate, top and bottom, both the cover plate has to fail at this junction. Then this connection will come off. Okay, imagine. See, if the plate cuts at this portion, then there are still these bolts are there to hold this member with the cover plate with this member. So the critical section for the cover plate is very close to the butt joint. And also if you take other side or this zone, then again which has to be very close to the butt joint. So critical section is a very important when it comes to the failure pattern.